On behalf of the World Academy of Art and Science, allow me to express a very warm congratulations for your decision of the Parliament of Romania to create the Institute for the Advanced Study of Levantine Culture and Civilization, supporting a timely proposal made by former President Emil Constantinescu and also a distinguished member and fellow of the World Academy of Art and Science. The World Academy of Art and Science is composed of 730 individual fellows from different cultures, nationalities, and intellectual disciplines chosen for eminence in the arts, the natural social science, and the humanities. It was established in 1960 by distinguished individuals concerned by the impact of the explosive growth of knowledge. So its activities seek to address global issues related to the social consequences and policy implications of knowledge. Its first president and very many leaders of that time, including Albert Einstein, supported the creation of the World Academy. The spirit of the Academy can be best expressed in the words of Albert Einstein, quote, "The creation of our mind shall be a blessing and not a curse for mankind." So its fellows share the ambition to rediscover the language of mutual understanding. And the founders of the World Academy, when they created the Academy, they were thinking of functioning as an informal world university, as the highest scientific and ethical level in which deep human understanding and the fullest sense of responsibility will meet. It was not possible to have the World University at that time. Today, with new communications and information technologies, we hope to have this World University. So the World Academy of Arts and Sciences created a World University Consortium, which has been established since 2013 at a meeting at the University of California at Berkeley. So we are working, still hoping to have the World University, and certainly we will count on the collaboration and participation of the Institute of Advanced Studies for Levantine Culture and Civilization. It is indeed a great privilege and honor to be invited to serve on the Scientific Council of this new institute, since we also believe in the broad objectives and in particular as its stated mission, quote, "to create a culture of peace through dialogue between academia, religious leaders, and younger generations." The attaining peace not only in the Levantine area, but also we hope worldwide. This important initiative of the Romanian Parliament will certainly have an impact in the Middle East, in North Africa, the Balkans, and the Caucasus. But if we do that, if we do what President Constantinescu said a few years ago, is if within the Levant area a visionary political project can be achieved, a project adapted to the major changes of the present, it will contribute not only to creating a new identity of this area, but also to create a new concept on the future world under the sign of a new humanism. I believe very much in that. Unfortunately, my own country, Brazil, was a colony of Portugal for 322 years. And after that period, we had a monarchy of a father and son emperor that lasted until 1889. Portugal, unfortunately, is not really included in the Levantine area. So I hope that my staying here in this institute, I will learn more about the Levantine area. But I've been thinking, how can I share the knowledge of the institute with my colleagues and students in Brazil? So I'm very much thinking that when I go back home, I will try to establish some university, some research center in Brazil to connect with the institute here in Bucharest. Frankly speaking, I believe there's a tremendous potential for sharing this knowledge, in particular this particular interest in the culture of peace, peace in the world. That's a very urgent matter for all of us. So we wish all the success to the new institute in all its activities, to its director general, to its senior officials of the directorial college, and to its general staff. And we will certainly do our best to contribute to this very important work. And we are sure that the Institute will count with the continued support of the Parliament of Romania, its Chamber of Deputies in the Senate, and of the Governor of Romania. I thank you for your attention.